With the lid removed from your multi-cooker, add the pre-measured water to the pot. You want the bottom of the pot to be covered with a half an inch of water. Once the water is in the pot, a rack should be placed in the pot such that it will keep mask and bag above the water. If the rack is not tall enough, then you may place binder clips on its feet to increase the height as shown here. Alternatively, accessories such as a hard-boiled egg rack may also be used. Put on your gloves. Open the paper bag to allow the mask to be placed inside. It is best to handle the mask with one hand and place it inside the bag. Once the mask is in the bag, remove the gloves and discard them safely. Fold over the top of the paper bag and secure it closed with a staple or paper clip. Place the paper bag with the mask inside into the multi-cooker and close the lid securely. Select the sous vide function or similar function. You'll need to set the temperature manually. When prompted, enter the temperature at 149 degrees Fahrenheit, 65 degrees Celsius, and set the time to 30 minutes. Then press start. Please consult your owner's manual for your multi-cooker to complete the same steps. Press start and confirm that the cycle has started. Once it is running, leave the multi-cooker to complete the cycle. Once the cycle is complete, remove the lid following the manufacturer's instructions. Note the contents will not be under pressure when the sous vide function is used. Remove the paper bag containing the mask or masks from the multi-cooker and open the bag to allow the mask to dry. If multiple masks were placed into the paper bag, then remove them and set them out to dry on a clean, dry surface. An hour should be sufficient for the mask to dry. Once dry, examine the mask for any potential damage, including the nose foam, strap attachments, and other accessories. If there is any damage, then discard the mask. If not, then the mask is ready for reuse.